So back at Largo, working on my craft, trying to avoid future ice storms. Around that time, the film director, Paul Thomas Anderson, was hanging around at Largo. He had just had a big success with his first movie, Boogie Nights. And he was about to do another movie, and he got friendly with a lot of the people that performed at Largo. When I said to a bunch of us, hey, I'm doing this new movie, it's called Magnolia. I want to put some Largo people in it. Nothing big, just have people in small parts. It would just be fun to have you guys there. So I think, okay, great. And he says, why don't you come by my house on Sunday? We're going to read through the script. It'll be a lot of fun. We'll have you read a few different parts and we'll see which fits best. I think, okay. So I go to his house. Now, he had neglected to tell me that his house was a mansion. I understand that's very hard to fit into conversation and not seem gauche, right? Hey, come by my house on Sunday. Don't be freaked out that it's a mansion. But I wish he had told me, because I got there, I had never seen anything like this in my life, and I instinctively knew I did not belong in there, right? Now, this is in my memory, it was this gigantic mansion. It could have been a three-bedroom house, right? But this is more luxury than I've ever seen, and I'm standing out in front of this place like, I do not belong in there. The getting yelled at potential is enormous. I might as well be by the side of the road in an exterminator uniform standing next to two other stooges, right? So I go into this house and I'm met by an assistant to the production. The assistant says, hey, come on in. Did you have a chance to look at the script? And I said, no, I haven't. And the assistant says, oh. And I say, why did you make that noise at me? And the assistant says, well, it's kind of a big script, and you're responsible for about a dozen 2 to 3 line parts that are scattered throughout this very big script. And if you miss any of the roles that you're supposed to read, which is very easy to do because they are kind of hard to find in there, you would be bringing the entire reading to a halt. Let's take a look at that script then. So the assistant hands me the script, which is the size of the phone book. And I have to comb through this phone book size script and find all the parts that I am to read. And it's tricky because I don't know if you've seen the movie Magnolia, but the plot is everyone in the phone book starts talking to each other. So I have the script and I have the list of the characters that I am to play and the pages upon which they appear. So I am the first to arrive. I'm sitting at this table and I'm frantically flipping pages and circling the names of the characters that I'm to play so I don't miss any. Flipping and circling. Famous people start to show up and sit at the table. And I think to myself, do not look at those famous people. They will distract you from your flipping and circling. So I'm flipping, circling, flipping, circling. Finally, there is one seat left at the table right next to me, and in this seat sits Tom Cruise. And I say, do not look at Tom Cruise under any circumstances. Get back to your flips and circles. Well, I don't have a chance to ignore Tom Cruise because Tom Cruise taps me on the shoulder and says, hi, I'm Tom. Hi, the most famous person in the world. I'm Paul. Tom, did you say? I heard it's good to repeat people's names when you first meet them so you won't forget. Tom. Not Dom Cruise. So the reading begins. I'm terrified that I have missed some names in my flipping and circling. And of course I have. Of course I have. And I know this every time a leaden silence falls over the room. And I see the director pointing at me frantically as if to say, it's you, stupid. The seventh time this happens. The seventh time. I have ground the reading to a halt. Tom Cruise, laughing. taps me on the shoulder and goes, you gotta pick up on those cues, buddy. Do I need this from you? Hey everyone, if you're wondering who is wrecking this entire afternoon, the most famous person in the world would like to point that person out to you. So, reading ends. I run out of that place like it is on fire. And I feel like, okay, I have one chance to redeem myself at the actual filming. Get to the filming, and it is in an actual mansion, another mansion that is being rented for the day. And I think, right, it was twice the potential to get yelled at. It is a rich person's home, and it's a place of business for the afternoon. So I am freaking out being in this place. Never been on a movie set before. The director gathers everyone into the kitchen of this mansion. He is telling us what we're going to be doing that day. I'm trying to pay attention to him, but it's really tough, you know? I'm so racked with nerves that I can't concentrate on what he's saying because all I am thinking is, I don't know what to do with my arms. Right, he is talking and I'm just thinking to myself, how do arms go again? So finally, I espy in front of me, there's this, table. I'm in this little breakfast nook. There's this table. And I think, okay, why don't you lean on that table? You're now allowed to lean as much as you like. This will solve your arms problem. So I lean on the table. And you know those tables where it's not all one piece, but it's just like a tabletop that's resting on a base? It's really convenient if you want to take the tabletop off and clean it separately, or if you want to lean on one end of it and send a bunch of cups and bottles flying all over the place. Well, I was not taking the tabletop off to clean it. So I lean on this thing, and cups and bottles go everywhere. Every single person in the room goes, "Whoa!" Legendary actor Jason Robards. This was to be his final film. Shortly after the movie is released, Jason Robards will shuffle off this mortal coil and die before he goes to his reward. Jason Robards got to see me knock over these cups and bottles and go, "Whoa!" So the rest of the day, I'm convinced, well, everyone here hates me, and when they look at me cartoon style, I just become a pile of cups and bottles. It makes me even more nervous to perform my scene, which consists of three sentences. I have to say three sentences. I am on the phone with the actor, Philip Seymour Hoffman. Now, scene begins. I am in another room in the house. I am not on camera yet. I am literally phoning in my performance live on a phone in this rich person's study. I'm sure there were stuffed dead things in there. I'm listening to the scene take place. Just hearing it over a phone, it's Philip Seymour Hoffman and Jason Robards doing some of the acting of their lives. This high drama scene. All of the people in the cast and crew are like crowd around watching this happening. I'm on the other end of this phone thinking to myself, just say the things that you are supposed to say. Don't say things you are not supposed to say. Don't say things like a racial epithet or a recipe or your own name. I'm not even on camera. I'm not even on camera. So I'm sweating blood like our Lord in the garden. So, they film that scene, and I get through it, and then it's time for the camera to be on me, and I think, oh, how am I gonna get through this? This is gonna freak me out. I notice there's a lot less people around for my part of the scene than there was for the movie stars. The director might not even be there. It seems like someone just turned on the camera and walked out of the room. So I have my suspicion that my on-camera role will not make it to the finished product. The movie is about to come out. I am at Largo. I'm waiting to be introduced. I'm about to go on stage. And then there before me appears the director, Paul Thomas Anderson. He says, hey, I know you're about to go on. I just wanted to come down in person and tell you, I'm really sorry, but I had to cut you out of the movie. And I said, I totally understand. Thank you for having me at all. It was a lot of fun. I really appreciate it. He goes, yeah, listen. And just so you know, I'm not going to stay and watch your set. Not sure why that needed to be said. There's still such a thing as lying, right? For some reason, it was important for him that I know, oh, and I'm also cutting you out of my evening.